You know, this game has always been called the world's greatest cocktail party. Do you know what is going to happen here tonight? And up at St. Simon's and Jekyll Island and all those places where all those dog people have got these condominiums for 4 days? Man, is there going to be some property destroyed tonight?
Oh, Georgia weekend, Friday night. Dog people start feeling right. Getting Georgia groovy. I hunker down to the Bulldawg Boogie. Next morning I pack my pride. I fix some vittles up Southern Fry. I hit the road, it's time to ride. Down to Athens to watch my sweet Georgia dogs. Sweet Georgia dogs.
Jump to your feet. let's go dancing. Buck and wing on a dog day afternoon. Shaking silver legs at the bulldog hold down. There's a live in Georgia fiddles playing. Beneath the heavens, autumn sky. My blood runs red deep down in Georgia. Be a Dixie dog to the day I die. Singing Dixie songs in the Sanford sunshine. I can't deny my dance feet. Gotta get up. Athens autumn sky. My blood runs red deep down in Georgia. Be a Dixie dog to the day I die. When I die, I'm going to Georgia heaven. All my friends in a red and black parade. Marry me by Tanya.
Second, tick, tick, tick. Look at the second. Chargers defeated Florida 24 to 22.
Georgia good time, Georgia good time, Saturday. 30, the 35, the 40, the 45, the 50, the 45, the 40, 35. Kentucky leading 16-14. A minute and 46. A minute and 45. Dawgs are trying to save himself. Kentucky's in a 5-5. Backers are back a few yards. Tyburn throwing to Scott, complete over the left side of the 35, and they hit him on about the 31. Did he get out of bounds? I don't think so. 91, 90, 89 seconds. He threw in a flat to Scott, and they stopped the clock with a minute and 28. They put it on the 31. Gain was 8 yards. Georgia's got a first down on the 31. Now the clock's running against the Dawgs. 84, 83, 82 seconds. Georgia breaks Jay Russell out to the right. They've come down to the Kentucky 31. They're in an eye. The clock's against them. 75 seconds. Tyburn going to go to McLennan. He can't get in the middle. The trap didn't work. And he got hit on a 30 and only got a yard. They swept right and tried to run Willie back in on the grain in the middle. A minute three, a minute two. Tyburn looking at the sideline. They're on a 30. It's 16-14. 55, 54, 53. The whole stadium standing up roaring against Georgia, except that little bunch on the other side. Stadium trying to make him make a mistake. They go to McClendon outside. He got a block for the 25. McClendon to the 20. McClendon down to the 16. Did he get out? I don't know if he got out. 37. They call time there. Willie McClendon got outside. McClendon got from the 30 down to the... They haven't put the ball down. It's on a 16, I believe. They're on the 16. McClendon got 14 yards. 33, 32, 31 seconds, 30 seconds. Georgia's come flying back down to the Kentucky 16. One man split wide, 25, 24. Tyburn, McClendon driving in the middle, and they knocked him down to the 12. 18 seconds, 17, 16, 15, 14. Georgia might call time. I don't know. 11, 10, they're on about the 11, and now 8 seconds, the Dawgs call time. Georgia's called time. They are on the 11. They are on, no, they're on the 12. They got about 3 on the last shot. Now, guess what's coming up? Charlie Fales just came in. Rex Robinson has come in. Mike Garrett. Holy smokes, I talked to Robinson's folks in the lobby of the motel today, and he missed his first two tonight. The Dawgs are going to try and save themselves, 16-14 Kentucky. The whole ball game coming down to this. Rex Robinson out of Marietta, Georgia. 16-14 Kentucky with 8 seconds. The stadium standing. Well, some of them are upside down, but they're trying to stand. It's going to be held just inside the 19. It's set down. He puts it up. It looks good. Watch it. Watch it. Yeah, 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 yeah. Unconscious. 15-2, Tennessee leading. Crowd roaring against Georgia, trying to make them drop it so they can't hear. We hand it off to Herschel. There's a hole. 5, 10, 12. He's running over people. Oh, you Herschel Walker. My God almighty, he ran right through two men. Herschel ran right over two men. They had him dead away inside the 9. Herschel Walker went 16 yards. He drove right over Orange Church, just driving and running with those big thighs. My God, a freshman. 15-8. You think this isn't big right here? Do you realize what has happened in this thing tonight? Tennessee crashing off one side. We pitch it to Herschel. Going to get him out. 10, 8, 7, 5. Herschel, Herschel Walker. Kid out of Johnson County. He got a block in front of him out around the 6 or 7 and got inside of it and went in the corner standing. Give the guy some rest. Buck back, third down on the 8. In trouble. Got a block behind him. Gonna throw on a run. Complete to the 25, to the 30. Lindsey's got 35, 40. Lindsey's got 45, 50, 45, 40. Run, Lindsey. 25, 20, 50, 10, 5. Lindsey's got, Lindsey's got, Lindsey's got.
can't believe it. 92 yards, and Lindsay really got in a foot race. I broke my chair. I came right through a chair, a metal steel chair with about a 5-inch cushion. I broke it. The booth came apart. The stadium fell down. Now they do have to renovate this thing. They'll have to rebuild it now. This is incredible. I didn't mean to beg Lindsay to run, but I had to. 26-21. You know, this game has always been called the world's greatest cocktail party. Do you know what is going to happen here tonight and up at St. Simon's and Jekyll Island and all those places where all those dog people have got these condominiums for 4 days? Man, is there going to be some property destroyed tonight?
Georgia groovy, I hunker down to the Bulldawg Boogie. Next morning I pack my pride, I fix some vittles up Southern Fry. I hit the road, it's time to ride down to Athens to watch my sweet Georgia dogs. Sweet Georgia dogs. Georgia good time, wherever I want to be, doing the Bulldawg Boogie. Georgia weekends find me down in Athens with my sweet Georgia dogs. Sweet Georgia dogs. Money on the Bulldawg Bite. We're gonna Bulldawg Boogie tonight. Yeah, from Macon to Atlanta, Athens to Savannah, Bulldawg Boogie tonight. We're gonna Bulldawg Boogie tonight with my sweet Georgia dogs. That's right.
Last October, I believe it was, we was going to hold a tent service off at this college town, and we got there about dinner time on Saturday. And different ones of us thought that we ought to get us a mouthful to eat before that we set up the tent. And so we got off of the truck and followed this little bunch of people through this small little bitty patch of woods there. And we come up on a big sign. It says, "Get something to eat here." And I went up and got me two hot dogs and a big orange drink. And before that I could take every mouthful of that food, this whole raft of people come up around me and got me to where I couldn't eat nothing, up like, and I dropped my big orange drink. I did. Well, friends, they commenced to move, and they want so much that I could do but move with them. Well, we commenced to go through all kinds of doors and gates and I don't know what all, and I looked up over one of them, and it says North Gate. And we kept on going through there, and pretty soon we come up on a young boy, and he says, "Ticket, please." And I says, "Friend, I don't have a ticket. I don't even know where it is that I'm going." I did. Well, he says, "Come out as quick as you can." And I says, "I'll do her. I'll turn right around the first chance I get." Well, we kept on moving through there, and pretty soon everybody got where it was that they was a-going, because they parted, and I could see pretty good. I could. And what I seen was this whole raft of people a-setting on these two banks and a-looking at one another across this pretty little green cow pasture. Well, they was. And somebody had tuck and drove white lines all over it and drove posties in it and I don't know what all. And I looked down there and I seen five or six convicts a-running up and down and a-blowing whistles. They was. And then I looked down there and I seen these pretty girls a-wearing these little bitty short dresses and a-dancing around. And so I sat down and thought I'd see what it was that was going to happen. I did. And about the time I got set down good, I looked down there and I seen 30 or 40 men come running out of one end of a great big outhouse down there. They did. And everybody where I was a-setting got up and hollered. And about that time, 30 or 40 come running out of the other end of that outhouse and the other bank full, they got up and hollered. And I asked this fellow that was besetting beside of me, I says, "Friend, what is it that they're hollering for?" Well, he whopped me on the back and he says, "Buddy, have a drink." Well, I says, "I believe I will have another big orange." And I got it and sat back down. And when I got down there again, I seen that them men had got in two little bitty bunches down there. They had rail close together. And they voted. They did. They voted and elected one man apiece. And them two men come out in the middle of that cow pasture and shook hands like they hadn't seen one another in a long time. And then a convict come over to where they was a-standing, and he took out a quarter, and they commenced to odd man right there. They did. Well, after a while, I seen what it was that there's odd manning for. It was that both bunches full of them men wanted this funny-looking little pumpkin to play with. They did, and I know, friends, that they couldn't eat it because they kicked it the whole evening and it never busted. But anyhow, what I was a-telling was that both bunches full wanted that thing. And one bunch got it, and it made the other bunch just as mad as they could be. And, friends, I seen that evening the awfulest fight that I have ever seen in my life. I did. They would run at one another and kick one another and throw one another down and stomp on one another and grind their feet in one another and I don't know what all. And just as fast as one of them would get hurt, they'd tote him off and run another number. Well, they'd done that as long as I sat there. But pretty soon, this boy that had said, "Ticket, please," he come up to me and he says, "Friends, you're going to have to leave because it is that you don't have a ticket." And I says, "Well, all right." And I got up and left. And I don't know, friends, to this day what it was that there's a-doing down there, but I have studied about it. And I think that it's some kindly of a contest where they see which bunchful of them men can take that pumpkin and run from one end of that cow pasture to the other without either getting knocked down or stepping in something.
Well, I've had a piece of chicken. I've had a little drink. I've looked at all the girls, given one or two a wink. I'm sitting in my seat, radio to my ear. The Star Spangled Banner and the crowd's opening cheer. I've been waiting since last Saturday, see another one beat. Friends, it's time once again to let the big dog eat. It's time,
it's time
to let the big dog eat. It's time,
it's time
to hear the bulldog beat. It's time,
it's time,
it's time,
it's time,
it's time.
Five-point lead, and that's all, and Auburn driving and driving. They come down to the Georgia 36. And Campbell going to run it with the fullback and keep it and come outside, and Sam Dooley from behind climbed up on his back on the 38 and pulled him down. 5:54, Georgia leading 19-14, second down. He runs to the fullback and keeps it to the fullback, and he comes and gets three. And oh, what a big play. Third and 11. And here comes Randy Campbell to throw. Looks. Fires down the middle, complete on the 25. Carver hit him right away. Auburn's got a first down. Auburn coming down the field trying to win now. Boy, you talk about drama here with the whole conference praying against us. Dogs trying to hang on to this little five-point lead, 19-14. And they run to the fullback. He keeps it and gets hit right there. And they pitch it to Bo Jackson. He slides out and they hit him, but he went straight down to the 18. 3:33, Auburn driving, trying to win. Third down, big play, third down, big play. Campbell going to pitch it to Lionel. He got a block, and he got a first down, I think, on the 14. They got a measure, a championship hanging with 3:07. Auburn a long grind, and a first down by 4.5 inches. Auburn is 14 yards away from upsetting the Dogs and knocking us out of everything. They've just driven it and driven it. And the defense standing there and they're running it at us. 2:55 to go. Georgia leading 19-14. Needing a play of some kind, a break of some kind. And Campbell gonna go to the fullback, flag down. Watch it flag down. They bring it back out to the 19. Hunker down, you guys. And they pitch it to Bo Jackson. One man knocked him off balance and Flack came up and got him. Carver spun him 3-4 yards behind the line. He stumbled off and little Flack came up and hit him. And the ball is on the 21. And it's second down now and 17 with 2:05 to go. Auburn trying to break our hearts here. Again, you guys, hunker down. Auburn up to the line. Randy Campbell with a man blitzing. Carver got him from behind, back on the 30. And a loss on the play out of about 9. Oh, man, 2 big plays, 84 seconds. Watch this now. I hate to keep saying it, but hunker down. Wow. Now, 1:04, 64 seconds to everything. You didn't hear me, you guys. Hunker down. And Randy Campbell, they blitz him. He dumps it over the middle, and it's complete on the 25 to Ed West. West stumbles and falls on the 20. Timeout, Auburn. Timeout, 49 seconds. Ball in the 21. They got to go to the 4 for a first down. Fourth and 17. I know I'm asking a lot, you guys, but hunker it down one more time. Auburn up to the line on the 21. And Campbell, as they blitz on him, he threw a high, wobbly pass. They fight in the end zone. And the Dawgs broke it up. They broke it up. They broke it up. Ronnie Harris and Jeff Sanchez got up in the air. He had pressure up the middle. They pressured the quarterback, one man in the middle and one from the front. They pressured him. And they made him throw it. The Dawgs with 42 seconds. I won't ask you to do that again, you guys. Georgia students and fans standing and roaring. 23, 22, 21. Clock running, running. Oh, look at the sugar falling out of the sky. Look at the sugar falling out of the sky. And now everybody roaring. 3, 2, 1. And they're carrying Vince Dooley off the field. Dawgs have won it. The defense hunkered, didn't they? They did hunker. I know I'm asking a lot, you guys, but hunker it down one more time.
Take a little. What's left to say, boy?
Hunker down, John.
hunker down, you guys. Again, you guys, hunker down. I know I'm asking a lot, you guys, but hunker it down one more time. I won't ask you to do that again, you guys.
Back on the 1.5 second down for Tennessee. They need 1 yard and 2 feet for a touchdown. Francis is going to give it to the tailback Davis. He tried to bounce out and we hit him on the fork. Tennessee up to the line. Two men right, two men left. Four wideouts and one running back. 29 seconds. They're on the Georgia. Four. Francis back. And they sacked him.
They'll knock ya, ha, the whole rat off and sock ya. Duelist, junkyard dogs. Duelist, junkyard dogs. The dogs, the junk and the mad. The mighty, mighty tough, the man that's bad. We're big, we're little, we're. But yet, we tell our point of. Yet, duelist, junkyard dogs. Duelist, junkyard dogs. They'll bark, they'll howl. Man, those dogs are really, really proud. Junkyard dogs. Whoa, duelist, junkyard dogs. One. Junkyard aims to please. Ha. You come from duelist, junkyard dogs. Duelist, junkyard dogs. They'll sock ya, they'll slap ya. Ha. Let me say it again. They'll slap ya, they'll sock ya. The whole rat off and sock ya. They'll slap ya, they'll knock ya.
Georgia's got seven men on the line. Hatcher has a man rushing. They block the kick. It's bouncing around in the air. And Georgia's got it. Touchdown! Touchdown!
Taylor fakes, dumps it over the middle. Intercepted by Holt in the 42. Holt 35, 30. Holt down to the 25.
Taylor back. Going to throw a screen. And Holt intercepted. Holt intercepted on the 20. And they put him down on the 18. Terry Holt again.
throwing a long bomb in a corner, and there he is. And somebody broke it up with a great leap. Terry Hogue got up in the air. Hogue got up with one hand and broke up a cinch touchdown down there.
Leisinger coming out, looks at Herschel, the sideline, throws to him at a 37, complete to the 40, to the 45, to the 45, a 40, 35, a 30. There goes Herschel, there goes Herschel, touchdown. Going to give it to Herschel up the middle. He got a block and he sprung out. He ran by a man to five. And there goes Herschel stumbling. There goes Herschel. There goes Herschel. Touchdown! And they run to Herschel at the right tackle. He drives and spins and breaks to the 50, to the 45. There goes Herschel. There goes Herschel. There goes Herschel. Leisinger going to run the end around reversal. Tron Jackson, he got a block to the 40, the 35, the 30, the 25. Tron Jackson, touchdown, touchdown.
Leisinger run the option, and he pitches to Tron Jackson, and there he goes. Tron Jackson going, 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 going.
Georgia, Georgia. the whole day through. And just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Georgia, Georgia, a song of you comes as sweet and clear as moonlight through the pines. Other arms reach out to me, other eyes smile tenderly, still in peaceful dreams I see the road leads back to you. Georgia, Georgia, no peace I find, just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Georgia, Georgia, no peace I find, just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind, just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind, on my mind, on my mind, on my mind. On my mind, on my mind.